days, counting days since my love up and got lost on me. Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be filming this look for you, which as you can probably see by the title already, it's all completely cruelty free makeup. So if you've been following me on like Snapchat and Facebook and Instagram, you'll kind of know that I'm slowly transitioning all my personal makeup into cruelty free. I'm currently a vegetarian. I just decided that since I'm a vegetarian, is it not a little bit hypocritical for me to also be using makeup that's tested on animals? I took it upon myself to really do a lot of research on what brands aren't tested on animals and what brands are tested on animals, right from your hair care to your skin care to nail care, everything. Makeup and beauty regime wise. Gonna be doing a little bit of like a series, I suppose, on like different brands and like my skincare routine, my hair care routine, blah, blah, blah. I was contacted a couple of weeks ago by The Body Shop and they basically sent me this gorgeous package. It first kind of started out because they wanted to work with me to basically try out the Amazonian Survivor like multi-purpose balm, which is basically supposed to like revive your tattoos and make them super like, you know, back in. That's where it all kind of stemmed from, and when they contacted me I was like, oh my god, definitely, I'd be totally into it. I've been trying out a couple of their skincare products anyways. I'm currently converting onto cruelty free makeup and beauty, and they're like, oh my god, like, let's also send you some makeup bits. So I was like, amazing, this would be like a perfect video. So this isn't sponsored, I'm not paid to say this, by the way, but everything that I say in the video are my own thoughts and I haven't been swayed in any way. So without any further ado, if you'd like to see how I created this makeup look, I'm living for my skin. So if you want to see how I created this makeup look, then please keep watching. So I'm just going to use the Tarte Shape Tape. A little bit different to what I'd usually use, but like the title says, this is cruelty free. And my Illusion brush. I carved out my brow already because my camera was being a dick. So basically, I'm just going to prep the eye the same I would with Select Cover Up by MAC, but I'm just doing it with Tarte Shape Tape instead. And this is in the shade Fair, which is their lightest shade that they have. And the exact same way as you would with Select Cover Up, you just go on tap a tap a tap. This actually dries matte a lot quicker than Select Cover Up does. So I'm going to go on with this guy here. This is the Tartist Pro Palette. Straight into Innocent. And then I'm going to work in sections. So I'm just going to start working in the middle first. I'm building up that pigment as opposed to worrying about the blend. Y'all know the drill. And I'm just basically creating the shape that I want to have. So as you can see, it's quite like rounded. So I'm kind of going for that rounded shape. So I have to like really keep within my socket. So I'm keeping nice and tight. I'm not really going any further than that. So loads of people always ask me, like, do you set your lids after you put your concealer? No, I don't. I don't set my eyes at all. Basically, the shadows that I'm applying now are starting to set transition color, which is like the lightest of all the colors that you're going to use in the eye makeup. And that is what's being used to basically set the concealer that you've placed on. We're just taking it slow, working it in, doing nothing. So my next shade that I'm going in with then is this NYX color, and this is in Wild Orchid. I haven't used that yet, but I've had it for such a long time that I was like, do you know what? I'm just gonna use it. I'm gonna use it. Just picking up a small bit at a time. As per usual, I only kind of dip into a shadow. I place it, pick up a bit more, place it. Just gonna do that the whole way around the shape of the eye that you created with the last shadow. You're going to worry about the blend after you've laid this down. So you want to make sure you have your pigmentation first, nice and strong. So the edges aren't going to be totally blunt, but they're still a little bit more blunt than we would like them. Alarm? Oh, it's so rude.
Oh, that alarm.
And then, as always, we're going to go in with our previous brush. You don't have to pick up any extra shadows, but this is just to really blur those edges. So again, you're going in with your circular motions. Drama. So we're going to use these two shadows here. Like I said, this is Maud and Drama. So we're going to mix the two of those together. And I'm always starting at the very top of the crease here. Okay, so we're applying it, wiggling it, applying it, wiggling it. These Tardis Pro like colours, I just love them, like they're so gorgeous. They blend really nice, and best part about them is that they smell like chocolate, so you know, if you're craving a bit of chocolate, Tarte's got you covered. So I'm going back in with my Tarte Shape Tape and my Charles Fox Illusion brush as per usual. And I'm just picking up a small bit of that Shape Tape. And I'm gonna make my first mark. So basically what I'm doing is I've put my first mark. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna look up to the ceiling straight up and look back down. So you can see there that I have my second mark. So this mark here is the one we're going by. Next is we're gonna hug the inner corner of the eye, press down, and we've created this shape here. We're gonna connect it. We're gonna do to get our second mark is we're gonna go right to the last lash. We're going to place down our mark, so we have our third mark. We're going to connect that mark up to meet our first mark again. And there we have our basic cup crease. What I want to do though is I just want to lift it a little bit because that's going to lift my eye up a slight bit. So I'm just going to gradually that mark up a slight bit and connect the other two to that mark. This shade here, which is Vamp. So this is like a gorgeous kind of bluey, deep, deep purple shade. Go along where my liner will go. I'm just kind of creating a little bit of deepness there. God, that, sorry. Shut up! Burial, which is this one here, and a little lip brush, but it can just be any flat brush, really. I'm gonna pick that up. And I noticed when I was applying this, like, how beautiful is that? Like, it's so stunning. And it's super foiled. But now that I'm looking at the other eye, it seems to be, like, dulling down. So I'm going to go in with my liner now, and I don't know if you know, but all Wet n Wild stuff is completely cruelty free, and I'm pretty sure it is certified by the Leaping Bunny as well. Gonna like messily quickly fill that in. I said I'm gonna clean up that wing there, and I'm just gonna use my cellar water, and I'm just gonna slowly start cutting into that shape. I'm gonna go in with a little bit of Ben Nye glitter glue. I'm actually gonna check really quickly if Ben Nye is cruelty free because I'm not sure. Oh, okay, Ben Nye is cruelty free. Go Ben Nye. I'm glad you're in my video. Okay, I'm gonna go in with this little brush here. Kind of the thinner the better with this situation, especially to do like a glitter hook like I'm doing now. So how I do it is I pick up the glitter glue on my brush first and I map out around my cut crease. I would not class this as a cut crease, but just for argument's sake, because everybody else in the freaking world does. I'm gonna dip straight in to Rainbow Ride from Lit. Okay, and you literally just start pressing that onto the glue and it just kind of sticks just where you're putting it as opposed to like going everywhere else. Go back in with my Tarte Shape Tape. And I'm just picking up any old brush and I'm just patting that in. So like always, if it's a liquid, you pat it. And basically patting it just works it into the skin as opposed to it sitting on the skin. You don't want it to sit on the skin. It has to really be worked in there, and that's what makes your makeup last longer. So it makes it look more flawless and airbrushed, and that's what we're looking for. So just because I'm gonna be joining a foundation to it soon, I just blur the edges, just using light circular motions, just to get rid of that harsh line, so it's just a bit more blended. Okay, so we're gonna go back in with this guy here, that, and I'm just centering that. So I'm working that into the center of the eye first, blending it off. So I want the strongest pigmentation to kind of be at the front and center there. Gonna start working that color into like a V, so I want it to kind of taper down. Okay, going back in with my glitter glue now, I'm just gonna place that. Oh, I kind of struggle with this because my eyes are so sensitive. Okay, and again I just kind of apply that in like a V shape. Lash Hero Extension Fiber Mascara. And that's from The Body Shop, and this is in the shade Jet London. Oh my god, what is that? What is that? They're actually... oh my god, they're actually fibers.
I have to try that a day that I haven't got lashes on. I'm confused. Is this normal? Okay, that's a normal mascara on the other side.
Isn't this really the part that we've all kind of been waiting for? So this is the package that I received from The Body Shop. Hey, let's send you more stuff like beauty products. So of course I was like definitely totally up for trying it anyway, because I would never think of The Body Shop for makeup personally. And see how we get on. Clay foundation. So it's two MAC clay foundations. Obviously one is significantly lighter than the other. I think I'll probably be on the lighter spectrum, even though the lighter spectrum still kind of looks like it might be a little bit too dark, but we'll see anyway. Illuminating drops of glow, this honey tanning cream, so it's like a tanner, but it's a BB cream tanner, so like it's good for your skin as well as tanning your skin. So I'm excited to try that, but for today we're just going to focus on the makeup. Let me just read. So this says illuminating drops of glow, luster finish creating drops. We'll do like the Instagram tear thing that everybody does. Oh mom, I'm in with the cool kids now. This is what it takes now to be cool in the makeup world. It's like whether or not you dropped drops. They're kind of separating my concealer there a little bit. Use a little brush and like let the little brush work that in. Is that working? Now it really doesn't like the Tarte Shape Tape. It's like removing it. See, it's like removing it and making it patchy.
Okay, so I'm gonna go in with this foundation here. So this says matte coverage, 24 hours wear, breathable wear, and promotes clear looking skin and non-pore clogging.
I think this might be a little dark. Oh yeah, that's way too dark. We'll just work it in and work with it and see how we get on. Okay, so it smells fresh. It doesn't have like an overpowering odor, which I absolutely hate. I hate when foundations have like an overpowering odor. This is actually working out to be quite a full coverage foundation at this colour. It's just a little bit dark for me.
I'm not mad at that coverage though, I'm not mad at that at all.
I'm pretty happy with that actually. I was not expecting that at all. That's really nice coverage. Maybe I should have given the Body Shop a little bit more credit. Shade of beige. So what I'm gonna use this for is kind of like a contour base. For under the eyes, I'm just gonna again pat that down. I'm gonna use this guy and I'm kind of gonna focus along these two colors here. And around the hairline as well. Okay, so what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna jump into my Kat Von D Lock It Translucent Powder. I'm gonna pick up a small bit of that. And I'm just gonna start pressing that just around the eye area. Highlight, I'm going to go in with the Illamasqua OMG highlighter and I'm just going to go in with a little fluffy brush. Foundation has already actually given me quite a nice glow with that those glow drops underneath it. So I'm just kind of going to accentuate those a little bit more. And I curve that right around in a little slithery snake motion there. For my lips then, I'm going to go in with this Tartist Pro Paint in the little mini ones. So I'm just gonna, this is really dry. But this is a weird consistency. So the consistency of this is kind of very similar to what the Amazonian clay foundation is. Very strange. I wasn't expecting a liquid lipstick to feel like this. It still feels really moisturizing as well as clayish, if that makes sense. But I hope I never lose the bruises that you left behind. Give you my final thoughts on what I think about these products is the matte clay foundation, and I am overly impressed with this. When I think of the Body Shop, I just solely think of skincare, body butters, that kind of thing. That's kind of what I was brought up to know with the Body Shop. I mean, it's been around for donkey's years. You'd walk in there, kind of pick up a cream, a hand cream, a foot cream, that kind of stuff, a face mask, but I would never really go over to the makeup. I'd kind of be Body Shop makeup. It's Lush makeup. In my head, I'm just I wouldn't buy makeup from Lush. But now after trying this, I probably would try the makeup from Lush because I'm clearly an idiot. It was absolutely incredible. My skin feels amazing. I don't even feel I have any foundation on my skin, yet the coverage on this is insane. This is approved. I'm proving that. The illuminating drops of glow. I'm not gonna say I hate them because I haven't tried them out enough, and hate is a very strong word. I think they have left a gorgeous glow on my skin, but they didn't react well when I had put them over my concealer. So I don't know if that's because it doesn't react well over a product, so it definitely wouldn't be something that you'd put over. It would definitely be something to put under. I don't know if it would mix well with the foundation. I haven't tried that yet. Maybe I'll have to try that to give you my proper honest opinion on it. It's kind of pending approval. I just didn't like how it separated when I had put it on top of something, but perhaps it's not meant for that. Next then is the Lash Hero mascara, and to be honest, I just think mascaras are mascaras, and as you've seen in the video, I didn't really get to fully try it out properly because it has these weird fiber things on it that I didn't get to try out because I had put false lashes on. I'll have to try it out regarding the fibers and stuff like that, see if it works. I might do that on Snapchat. So if you haven't already followed me on Snapchat, follow me on Snapchat now. Thank you all for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. Maybe you learned something cool today, and perhaps I've swayed you into a couple of cruelty-free products, or maybe if you are currently changing your kit and your collection into cruelty-free, perhaps I've given you some ideas of where you can go and different products that might work for you.